encarecido anjo Ismael. Glória a Deus nas alturas. Paz aos homens na terra. Jesus, bom e amado Mestre, sustenta os teus humildes irmãos pecadores nas lutas deste mundo. Anjo bendito do Senhor, abre para nós os teus compassivos braços. Abriga-nos do mal. Levanta os nossos espíritos à majestade do teu reino. E infunde em todos os nossos sentidos a luz do teu imenso amor. Jesus, pelo teu sublime sacrifício, pelos teus martírios na cruz, dá a esses que se acham ligados ao pesado fardo da matéria, orientação perfeita do caminho da virtude, o único pelo qual podemos te encontrar. Jesus, paz a eles, misericórdia aos nossos inimigos, e recebe em teu seio bendito a prece dos últimos dos teus servos. Bendita estrela, farol das imortais falanges, purifica-nos com os teus raios divinos, lava-nos de todas as culpas, atrai-nos para junto do teu seio, santuário bendito de todos os amores. Se o mundo com os seus erros, paixões e ódios, alastra o caminho de espinhos, escurecendo o nosso horizonte com as trevas do pecado, rebrilha mais com a tua misericórdia, para que seguros e apoiados no teu evangelho, possamos trilhar e vencer as escabrosidades do carreiro e chegar às moradas do teu reino. Amiga estrela, farol dos pecadores e dos justos, abre o teu seio divino e recebe a nossa súplica pela humanidade inteira. Assim seja.
Our guardian angels are closer to us than anything, except God's love for us. Welcome, my beautiful brothers and sisters, connecting from all over Mother Earth on this glorious Kazaday full moon. There's a lot going on as we all come together as one family, connecting to the portal of the Casa de Dominacio, the house of love, where the medicine is love, here in Avellaneda, in the heart of Brazil. And we have another spectacular day here, although it's very hot. I hope our equipment doesn't melt like it did yesterday. Let's pray. We have a deep blue sky, and the sky unites us, reminding us of the mantle of our Divine Mother, her love and protection. And not a cloud in the sky, but we have butterflies flitting around slowly, and they remind us of our transformation, that we are just travellers here on earth, and that all things pass and all things are impermanent. And you may be able to hear the birds outside. They're so busy and glorious. They are serenading us in a divine symphony with their sacred bird song. They're so beautiful. So as we settle deeper and deeper into this divine work, let us relax as much as we possibly can and put our intention into doing the deepest work possible. If you're lying down, this is great. If you're under a crystal bed, even better. And if you are sitting upright, let's elevate our heads just a little so this energy can flow fluidly, freely and easily, connecting us across the miles like a river a current of love and light. Just don't close your body in any way. Be open to give and receive in this beautiful high vibration that we're all multiplying here, now, in this moment. And put a glass of water beside you. This will be blessed, and we'll drink it at the end of the work to nourish us, mind, body, and spirit. And as we close our physical eyes, leaving the material world behind, with all of its stresses and its difficulties and its problems, particularly now, we take this time to open our spiritual eyes, where we can see beyond appearances, all there is. We are reminded again and again, we're not the body, we're so much more, we're more than we think. The body merely houses our eternal spirits. And we're not living eternally in these physical bodies. We have an expiration date. We move in and out of perishable bodies. So let's seize this moment now and really go deep into our heart center. And we have an infinite amount of help available to us, sent by God, all of these messengers of love. And today is the feast day of our guardian angels. We've had angels galore this week. Michael, Gabriel, and Raphael earlier in the week. They too are our guardians. But we have specific guardian angels, which God made for each and every one of us. And it's comforting to parents as a belief that an angel protects their little ones from dangers, real and imagined. Yet guardian angels are not only for children. Their role is to represent individuals before God, to watch over them always, to aid their prayer, and to present their souls to God at the hour of transition. Angels are assigned to guide and nurture each human being. Angels are spirits, so they don't have bodies like ours, but we can picture them with bodies, wings, and halos. Because this is how they appear to people sometimes, and it helps us to think about them. Your angel is always with you, all the time, 24/7, even though you can't see him or her. I'd say a big number of our children's imaginary friends are guardian angels too. And your angel has three important jobs: to enlighten you, guide you, and protect you. And sometimes they work overtime with all of us, but we're just doing the best we can. And although your angel may help to protect you from earthly harms, sometimes it's more important job for your angel to protect you from spiritual harms. They work with us on all levels, mind, body, and spirit. And God gave you the special gift of free will. So even though your angel can help you in many ways, it is still possible for you to choose to do bad, negative, or dangerous things. Sometimes we're not perfect beings, we're working on it. We just need to be careful. From our birth to our passing, we are surrounded by the protection and intercession of angels, particularly our guardian angels. And the scripture tells us, beside each believer stands an angel as protector and shepherd, leading him or her through life. Guardian angels are our bodyguards. And we thank God for our helpers, the angels, particularly on this feast day, as we nurture devout gratitude to God for having placed these heavenly spirits of great sanctity and dignity at the service of humanity. Now, it may be a leap of faith for some, yet there are many realities whose existence has not been proven by mere sight. So we are accustomed in the Casa, certainly, to live by faith and not by sight. The invisible operations that were done at the casa certainly manifested physical stitches in people's bodies. So we're working with this magnificent high vibration. And we are embracing our faith in all of these magnificent messengers, servants of God, sent to us, particularly today, our beautiful guardian angels. So let us, in gratitude, pray. Jesus told us many, many centuries ago that when a few are called in his name, he will be present. Trusting the promises of the Christ consciousness, may Christ return to earth. And Jesus gave us all this beautiful gift, bestowing upon his 12 apostles many, many moons ago, the very high vibration of the Lord's Prayer that has come down to us through the ages, teaching us how to pray, how to talk to God, our Creator, how to forgive ourselves and forgive our brothers and sisters, how to surrender to the will of God Almighty, thy will be done, not my will. And to embrace all of these beautiful gifts of creation that we have received and continue to receive in each and every moment. So let us pray with open hearts, joyfully, trustingly, without ceasing. The Lord's Prayer, translated from its original Aramaic, the language of Jesus and Mary. O birther, father, mother of the cosmos, you create all that moves in light. Focus your light within me and make it useful. As rays of a beacon, show the way. Create your reign of unity now. Through my fiery heart and willing hands, your one desire then acts with mine. As in all light, so in all forms. Grant what I need each day in bread and insight, subsistence for the call of growing life. Loosen the cords of errors binding me as I release the stranglehold of others' guilt. Do not let surface things delude me. Rather, liberate me from what holds me back from my true purpose. From you is born all ruling will, the power and the life to be, the song that beautifies everything as it renews from age to age. Truly, power to these words. May they be the source from which all of my actions grow, sealed in trust and in faith. Amen. As we turn now to our Divine Mother, the Mother's Heart, the Feminine Power, Mother Earth, Queen of Peace, we ask you in this sacred moment to intercede for us, your children, to somehow alleviate the suffering of humanity in these challenging days on Mother Earth. And help us to go on the inner journey of the heart, to find the peace, the harmony, the tranquility, the humility, the compassion, the love, the forgiveness, the gratitude, the joy, deep, deep within us. And it is within all of us. We are divine beings, helping us all incarnate and disincarnate on our healing journey back home, merging into the light, out of separation, into oneness. One heart, one soul, one light, one love, one family. We invoke the Great Mother, Father, and Holy. Holy Spirit. Sacred Trinity of innumerable names, we invoke you, Lady of Medicine, healer of all infirmities. We invoke you, Queen of the universes, heavens, seas, and lands. We invoke you, Sovereign of Spirituality, so that your light may descend upon us all and illuminate our paths. Amen. always and ever surrounded by unseen beings. And certainly these magnificent entities of the casa work tirelessly around the clock to help us. We just need to reach out and ask with a contrite heart, and we will receive. And we have a phenomenally high vibration working through the portal of the casa in the form of a beautiful angel called Ishmael. He is the guardian angel of Brazil, as many countries have their guardians. And he is invoked by the many spiritists here in Brazil as a comforter, a consoler. And he has a huge phalange of light workers, an infinite amount of unseen beings available to help us in every way possible. He did a lot of work with the slave ships coming in through Salvador here in Brazil. And of course, slavery exists today. Shame on us. We need to eliminate this horror. And the good news is that Ishmael will transmute all denser energies through the Christ consciousness into divine light and love. He is our friend. Just like our guardian angels, he is always by our side when we call upon him. He is especially good to implore for all obsessions, as the casa is the biggest de-obsession house in South America. He is particularly effective when we ask for help with all addictions, with drugs, alcohol, sex, porn, even social media, which has become a plague for many. With all disorders, he can help, diseases, disharmony, any illness, anxiety, mental disturbances, doubt, anguish, depression, gossip, anything, everything that's hazardous to our mind, body, and spirit. He is amazing, and he never works alone. The hosts of angels are working with him, and he does phenomenal work with suicidal tendencies and helps to rehabilitate those who have already taken their lives. So great hope here. We are so loved by these messengers of God. The entities know no borders, no boundaries, no time or space. Angel Ishmael will come immediately. He is available to us now and always. And he will bring all of our petitions on wings of power to the altar of God. Let us pray. Glory to God in the highest, and peace to men and women on earth. Jesus, good and beloved Master, sustain your humble, erring brothers and sisters in the battles here on earth. Ishmael, blessed angel of the Lord, open for us your compassionate embraces. Protect us from lower vibrations. Lift our spirits to the majesty of your kingdom, and infuse in all of our senses the light of your immense love. Jesus, through your sublime sacrifice, through your martyrdom and suffering on the cross. Give to those who find themselves burdened with weighty clothing and denser energies. Give to them the perfect orientation of the path of virtue, the only path that can help us find you. Jesus, peace to them, forgiveness to our enemies, and receive in your blessed breast the prayer of the least of your servants. Blessed Star, Lighthouse of the Immortal Phalanges, purify us with your divine rays. Cleanse us of all of our guilt. Attract us to move close to your breast, the blessed sanctuary of all love. If the world with its errors, passions and hates strews the path with needles, darkening our horizons with heavier energies, brighten more with your forgiveness, in order that secure and aided in your message, we can overcome the difficulties of the way and reach the dwellings of your kingdom. Friend, Star, Lighthouse of both the sinners and the just, open your divine breast and receive our supplication for all of humanity. Let it be thus. Amen. Since time immemorial, great scholars, saints, holy people have been writing about angels, guardian angels, in many different traditions: Christianity, Islam, Judaism, Zoroastrianism. I must look that one up. And it's a great reminder that we're not alone. We have so much help from beyond the veil. God did not bring us this far to abandon us, and we're all held in this beautiful high vibration of love and light. God has sent all helpers to us. And a beautiful entity of the Casa, Saint Augustine, who helped Saint Rita through the walls of the convent in Cassia to become a Augustine nun. He explains of angels, and this is going back 500-600 years ago. If we journey into another country, they follow us. Go where we will, by land or by sea, they are ever with us all day long and all night long, and during every moment of our life. Our guardian angels aren't assigned by God merely to protect us from physical harm or even death. Some angels do protect us in that way, but these invisible protectors are primarily concerned with keeping us on a path that leads to God. And another magnificent entity of the Casa, Saint Benedict, the holy abbot that founded the Benedictine order in the 6th century. Appeared inside his cell, where he witnessed the apparition of a globe held by three angels in the presence of the Trinity. And our beautiful Padre Pio, who bore the stigmata of our brother Jesus, he was always reminding us of our guardian angels. He could actually see them. And once a person is accepted as Padre Pio's spiritual child, he will never abandon them, no matter what danger they were in. And even if Padre Pio didn't visit them personally, because he used to bilocate, his guardian angel was sent instead to help people invoking Padre Pio for help. And Padre Pio said, angels travel faster than aeroplanes. He reminds us that our angel is ready to go anywhere on our behalf. And we too can send our angels where we cannot go ourselves. Pio reminds me that if I can send my angel to greet others, to bring messages of light and hope, and to comfort them in their affliction. And even when Jesus was alone in the Garden of Gethsemane, there appeared to him an angel from heaven, strengthening him in his hour of need. So the same thing happens when people we love are alone, feeling abandoned and in agony. We can send our angel to strengthen them. How great is that? It's all about intention. Our angel, particularly in these challenging days, can go to the elderly in nursing homes who long for visitors but cannot have any right now, and comfort them. Our angel can go to people who live alone and ease their solitude. Our angel can go to children without anyone to play with and make them laugh. Our angel can go to people struggling with depression and loneliness and lift their hearts. Our angel can go to our loved ones who are sick or scared or heartbroken and strengthen them as the angel in the garden strengthened Jesus. In times of our greatest need, we are never helpless. We need to remember this. Our guardian angel is ready and waiting to give the supernatural assistance that heaven alone can provide. And let us absorb these beautiful words of Scripture, reminding us that we're never alone. For he will give his angels charge of you, to guard you in all your ways. On their hands they will bear you up, lest you dash your foot against a stone. Amen.
Thank you.
And as we embrace this beautiful...